Hello, welcome to your academy. At your academy today, in this lecture, we will deal with Louis Althusser's concept of ideological state apparatus and repressive state apparatus. Louis Althusser is known for ideology and ideological state apparatus. But since we have dealt with the theory of ideology by Louis Althusser in detail, if you have not gone through the lecture on theory of ideology at your academy, you can check out the link given at the top of this video to watch that lecture. Now, after you have watched that lecture and understood the theory of ideology, you can come back and watch the lecture on ideological state apparatus. And if you have already watched, then this is the continuation of our lecture series on Louis Althusser's theory of ideology. And in this particular lecture, we will deal with his two most important concepts, ideological state apparatus and repressive state apparatus. Now, just a reminder that Louis Althusser is a Marxist critic, and Marxism is a theory which particularly deals with the power structures, with the class struggle, and with the cultural studies. Now, since when it comes to the power structures and when it comes to the class struggle, ideology becomes an important aspect or an important part. And if you have watched the lecture on theory of ideology, you must have understood the function of ideology is not to produce knowledge, but the function of ideology is to make people obedient. Now, it is very imperative or important for the ruling class to spread its ideology among its masses, or make the citizens which the ruling class governs or rules obedient. Now, how does ruling class make the citizens obedient? Louis Althusser says it does so through ideology. Now, if ideology becomes a component for the ruling class to maintain its dominance and its powers, there are two important tools which any ruling class or any ideology would make use of to maintain their dominance. And those two important, tools are ideological state apparatus and repressive state apparatus. Another important question that struck Louis Althusser when he was dealing with theory of ideology, or when he was dealing with this cultural analysis or understanding the culture, he said that the relationship between the ruling class or the governing class or the productive class and with the laborers is that of exploitation. And this is one of the main issues of Marxism. It would always tell you that capitalism exploits the laborers, and Marxism is in opposition to capitalism. And since the relationship between a worker and its employer is based on exploitation, so Louis Althusser asked the question that why does a worker allow himself or herself to be exploited without any resistance? Or, for example, he said, why does exploited allow himself to be exploited always? So, in order to answer this question, Louis Althusser said that a laborer, a worker, a member of the lower class society or lower class allows himself to be exploited because of ideological state apparatus and repressive state apparatus. Because a worker has not got that much of option with him left that he can resist. Ideological state apparatus and repressive state apparatus, when they come into use, they leave very narrow margin for the people to retaliate, for the people to resist, for the people to revolt. So what are these repressive state apparatuses and ideological state apparatus? These are the body of institution that state has. As the word apparatus suggests, they are tools, they are equipments, they are methods in the hands of the states to control the subjects. So if any subject at any point of time rebels against the state, so it would depend on nature of the rebelliousness that the tool will come into action. For example, if someone, goes way beyond or out of the control of the state and raises, a violence kind of objection towards the state, in that scenario, state would come up with repressive state apparatuses to curb that particular uprising. And if there is any other violation, say for example, a violation in not doing proper duty, a violation of not, you know, adhering to the codes of conduct, in that case, ideological state apparatus, you know, non-violent physical forces may come into force, and that particular individual or a person would be subjected to be obedient to the ruling class. So what are the repressive state apparatuses? Althusser says, and I quote, "The state apparatuses contain the government, the administration, the army, the police, the courts, the prison, etc., which constitute what I shall in future call the repressive state apparatus. Repressive suggests that the state apparatus in question functions by violence, at least ultimately, since repression, for example, administrative repression may take non-physical forms." So what are the state apparatuses, or what are the repressive state apparatuses? It are the government, police, courts, prison, army. Now say for example, there is an uprising, there is an emergent in terms of Raymond William. If you want to know more about the emergent and dominant and residual of Raymond Williams, you can, you know, click the link given at the top of this video, and we have all delivered a lecture on Raymond Williams' model of cultural analysis wherein he talks about emergent. Now if there is an emergent, and that is oppositional emergent against the ruling class, so to curb that voice, what ruling class would do? It would use the repressive state apparatus. For example, there would be arrests. For example, the people would be taken into the custody. And if still they do not, you know, accept the ruling, the ideology of the ruling class, they would be put in prison. And you know, these are the repressive elements which state has got, or tools which state has got to repress any uprising against them. And this repressive state apparatus always functions, you know, not always, rather mostly functions through oppression or violence. You know, the violence of this repressive state apparatuses would be even non-physical. It would be physical. For example, in certain cases, if police is made to act, or army is made to act, you know, it could be a violent kind of an action from the state. On the other hand, there could be administrative repression also. Say for example, if an employee doesn't do his job properly, he would most probably be suspended, his salary would be curtailed, or at the most he would be dismissed from his services. So that is another way or form of oppression that state has with itself, or repression that state has with itself. And that is why you will find in most of the capitalist democratic societies, an employee of the government is not allowed to speak against the government. You know, whatever the scenario be, the employee has to speak in favor of the government, because if he speaks against the government, there are high chances that he would be suspended, he would be dismissed, there could be other actions that would be taken against him, and the state has set already all those rules and laws. So any employee who is a state employee will not dare to go against the government, to go against the state, or to go against the ruling class. So that is one of the, you know, tools that state has to maintain its power, to maintain its dominance, or to maintain its ideology.